Hi guys, in this video I will explain you how to install an M.2 SSD on your motherboard. The procedure is done in three simple steps. First, find an appropriate slot. Second, insert and secure the SSD. And third, install the heat spreader. To choose the slot, check your motherboard's manual to find the fastest one available. The slot labeled with CPU or from CPU is directly connected to the processor and provides faster communication than those labeled chipset or from chipset. If you have multiple slots from the CPU or this information is not specified, choose the one with the highest PCI Express version. If you're installing a SATA M.2 SSD, make sure that the slot supports the SATA standard. Also, if you're using multiple 2.5-inch SSDs or hard drives, make sure that this slot does not disable a SATA port that is already in use. Usually, the slot closest to the CPU socket is the fastest one. This slot may be covered with an M.2 shield or heat spreader, which you may need to remove. Next, check that the standoff is in the correct hole corresponding to the length of your SSD. If it's not, unscrew the standoff and move it to the appropriate one. Then check the orientation of the drive. In most cases, the side with the sticker or heatsink should be facing up. Insert the SSD at about 30 degree angle and make sure that when you press it down, it is lifted back by the spring mechanism. Keep in mind that heavier SSDs with a heatsink may have only a slight movement. If the SSD is not inserted properly, it will usually fall straight onto the standoff. Securing the drive to the standoff is typically done in one of three ways: with a screw, with Q-Latch, or with the so-called EZ Latch. Now check if your heat spreader is secured to the same standoff as the SSD. If it is, you need to secure the SSD while placing the metal plate. To do this, remove the plastic cover from the thermal pad and keep the screw that secures the SSD attached to the plate. Press the SSD down with one hand and then lower the side of the heat spreader with the common screw over the standoff. Screw it in and then fasten the other screw. If the plate is installed in a different hole, secure the drive to the standoff first, as this will make installing the heat spreader easier. Don't worry about the screw sticking up. It is lower than the top of the ICs, and in many cases, manufacturers leave a hole in the thermal pad. To secure the SSD with a Q-Latch, you just need to move the black plastic piece over the semicircle of the drive. Here's how it's done. First, press the SSD so it goes under the screw. Then use a screwdriver tip to rotate the latch over it. If the SSD cannot go under the screw, rotate the latch clockwise or counterclockwise so it's out of the way. Then press the drive down and rotate the latch. If you still cannot press the drive down, loosen the screw slightly with a screwdriver and try again. In some cases, the PCB of the drive might be a little bit thicker and still not latch properly. For example, on this motherboard, I found that this drive could not fit under the Q-Latch. So in that case, simply take another latch from the box and replace it. If your SSD comes pre-equipped with a heatsink, you don't need to install the heat spreader. Just store it in your motherboard's box. If you're using an EZ Latch, the drive will simply lock in place when you press it down. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like the video if it was helpful and subscribe if you wish to see more similar content. Also, feel free to share your thoughts in the comments below. See you soon!